I call upon the first prize winner, M. Sanjana Reddy of Class 8 in senior category of Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan's ATMAKURI RAMA RAO School, Jubilee Hills, to deliver the speech on how can we best celebrate Gandhiji's 150th birth anniversary.
Namaste to the divinity in one and all present as a part of this August gathering here today. My humble pranams to our revered chairman, Sri S. Gopalakrishnan sir, and all the dignitaries. I am Sanjana of Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan's ATMAKURI RAMA RAO School, representing our team of Bhavanites. It gives me immense pleasure and a deep sense of responsibility to be present here before you to express my perspective on how best we can celebrate Gandhiji's 150th birth anniversary. When I reclined and thought of all our meticulous celebrations on October 2nd every year, all that came to my mind were contests in elocution, arts, garlanding his portrait, singing bhajans, etc. It left me pondering if we really understand Gandhi at all. This martyr from Porbandar unquestionably is much more than mere flesh and blood, much more than mere words, and much more than an individual. His life is not just a simple existence, but a message by itself. Celebrating such a personality, according to me, must not stop with such flowery events, but enhance the Gandhian spirit and values amongst the people. His doctrine of love your enemy and pray for his well-being too must be instilled in the minds of the very buds in the blooming society of our country. In the book Gandhi, A Very Short Introduction, Bhikkhu Parekh has presented a rewarding appreciation of Gandhi's unique and unsurpassed spiritual, political and social thoughts. Gandhiji's critique of violence in this particular book is simply staggering. I shall quote a few lines now. In Gandhiji's view, violence oozed from every pore of modern society and had so much become a way of life that human beings today are in danger of losing the capacity to notice its pervasive presence, let alone finding ways to dealing with it. When this man in Khadi could inspire Martin Luther King Jr. of a faraway land, who is quoted saying, "Christ showed us the way and Gandhi in India showed it could work." After the Montgomery bus segregation was ruled out by the Supreme Court. Why aren't we? No, I refuse to accept or fancy presuming the spirit of Gandhi alive in ourselves unless we live like one. Follow his ways and hold dear the weapons of satyagraha, ahimsa and non-violence in this tempestuous world. We are to answer to ourselves the question of being able to remain true to the Gandhian spirit in the face of adversity. It is rightly said that Gandhi lived a simple life so that others might simply live. Gandhi is also quoted saying, "Be the change you want to see." Isn't it inspiration enough to start afresh and take a lead in sculpting a society into a well-developed, unique, educated, and most of all, a humane one? Wouldn't it be one of the best tributes to this great soul to live and offer a life of love and truth? Don't you think it would just suffice to let him lead us in our simplest thought, word or deed to bring about that change our heart aches to find? Yes, let us all determine and unrelentingly follow the footprints embedded in the sands of our country's history to make our motherland spiritually stronger, physically safer and emotionally a sounder place to set foot into. Let us give Gandhiji the nation he had dreamt of, fought and died for. Let us celebrate him, his ideals, and make it our way of life. On the occasion of celebrating his 150th birth anniversary, let us pledge ourselves to be bold enough to stand up for the right and be fearless, to deal with others in an unbiased manner and respect diversity to promote peaceful coexistence, to develop a humane attitude towards the downtrodden and contribute to their upliftment. Be able to see the dignity of labor and follow the principle of work is worship. Last but not the least, adapt to simple living, catering to our needs rather than our wants. Gandhiji himself had said, there is enough for everybody's need, but not for anybody's greed. By following these, I envision a tremendous change in our own self, the society and country on a larger perspective. What best can we give him except this? Let the change start from us, now and here. Jai Hind.
Thank you, Sanjana.